you could please take the roll.
Dr. Thompson, Amy Barney, here. Alfred Dixon.
Here.
Marcia Goff.
Here.
Julie Pete.
And we'll stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I don't think we have any items for executive session. Is that correct? Not that I'm aware of anyway. Mr. Collins?
No.
And we have one call to the public, it looks like, from Catherine Huber. You want to stand and use that microphone over there? Well, yeah, we have to be able to hear you and record you and... Okay. Thank you. Okay. Next item is old business. We have a motion to, I don't really think that doesn't need a motion. We just need to update that old business. So update on the clinic closure. Yeah, and I think I had given Storm a thumb drive that had everything I had, and it was there's one list on there that is everything that was gifted to the district to set up the CTE room, and then there's another list that Jamie had actually created when we closed it, and it's like 7 pages long, so that's kind of where we started. But that includes like all kinds of little peripheral stuff that we obviously aren't going to sell. But my thought was, again, and I think we had talked about this, was once we, you know, put this out, you know, for sale, it'll be a one and final kind of a, you know, maybe give a couple of hours for somebody to come through. But I thought it'd kind of be nice to do it in a cooler month because it's just too darn hot right now. And, you know, it's in storage, and, you know, we have to give sort of a, you know, fair market value price, and then whatever our, you know, and then we don't have to give a low bid price or anything. It's just whatever somebody wants to offer, and then it's going to be first and final. And I think that that's probably going to be the best thing to do. And I had delivered a check to Mr. Murray for what had already been purchased, and that was like, it was a long time ago, whenever our last meeting was or before that. So I think as far as the inventory, except for some of the smaller items, we have the, you know, we have two exam tables, but the otoscopes and things like that, that are, they're smaller items, but they're very expensive items. And, I mean, with an average of 7 patients a day, I don't think they would use that much with 3 exam rooms. But whatever they are, everything I saw was in good working order, except for 1 BMI scale. So maybe we can... We'll check back with Julie between now and our next meeting, and I think our next meeting is scheduled for October, so maybe we can plan to do something then and have it sometime later that week or that month or something. Yeah, me too, because I'm assuming the warehouse isn't air-conditioned. Maybe it is. I don't know, but even if it isn't, a lot of people coming in and out, and just having cooler weather, I think, would prompt more people to come out. And Julie did have... she has quite an influence, or not influence, but just, I mean, she knows all of the providers and all the offices in town, so she can, you know, in addition to us publishing it on the Havasu website, maybe putting it in the paper or something, she can kind of reach out to everybody and say, okay, here it is. And then, Storm, you've got pictures now of everything.
From the
program. Mm-hmm. So I think from there we'll be able to, if we want to have like a, you know, place where people want to look at the picture before they come over or something like that. They can do that. I think that'll probably work. Yes, please. Okay. So to new business, we have a motion to approve the new business agenda, 4.1 through 4.4, and we'll just go through each one.
So moved.
Second.
Yes.
Thanks, Madam Chair. On item 4.1, just to give a quick update on the open enrollment. So the district did do the open enrollment from April 22nd to May 10th. They're showing a total of 13 employees who actually enrolled in the high deductible health plan. There were some issues on here in the that we're still working through with the transfer of the files back and forth. The district had a new employee enrollment software, so pretty much typical for all students. So we're continuing to work through those. It's a smart application. We're working through all that stuff to get all the cards, make sure they're correct, and we're not going to have the depth difference.
Yeah, that kind of looks like, what?
Yeah. But then we also, obviously, the SPCs went out and also summary plans out to then upload them to the district website. So pretty much everything's on that course. We got at the bottom of the page, we have an email that came through from a retiree. Talked about the rates. We're going to have to get back with Mike on this because this is saying there's a 20% increase. We didn't come back to 20%. So we came back to it. They went from gold to gold.
Right.
It was 7.3, and silver, the high deductible was 3. So we're not sure exactly how that all worked. We will get back. And then I mean, the only other thing we would just point out of this is he's taken on the face value. So that was a focus down box and access. All went down fairly dramatically in that period of time. So this, once we had an idea how the math was working, we actually send application back to the deal. And when you look at the deductible, depending on which plan they were on, but from the PPO, we're talking about a deductible that went from 3,500 individual, 7,000 family,
right,
down to 750 on the family. So there's even at the point.
Yeah, and I think, I guess my concern was that the retiree felt like he or she, I don't know if it's a male or female, wasn't being taken care of. And I guess because when I think of all of the benefits, I think of it for everyone that's covered, which would be employees and retirees. And the changes that we made were pretty significant to the good, as far as I could see. And like you said, I couldn't come up with the 20%. Because it wasn't. So I, and then just maybe circling back around, verifying that, and then circling back around with this person. And then could you also maybe check with Mr. Murray and just ask him to post those retiree rates with the other ones, because normally they're all on the same page, and I could find the rate page on the website, and it's done very well. I mean, it's very easy to find, and you know, the plan documents and everything's broken out. I really like the way that's done, but the only one I could find was last year's for retirees. So I think it would be nice to have that on there.
And then moving on to the second page, on the renewal. So the trustees will remember that the stop loss renewal came in much higher than what we had projected, either on a conservative basis. So what we did, we've got final copy of the budget here we can pass out. We took the $8.52 per employee per month, and that budget is left over for the clinic. We removed that. And then we wound up, we had this basically shift from the claim funds to get it to balance. So just on a dollar basis, because it varies depending on which year you're in, but on a dollar basis, the net effect is reduced the claim fund by about $231,000 in addition to what we took from the clinic side to get it to balance. Okay. So just kind of FYI. Teladoc, we updated that in the budget to reflect that the high level of plan members have a $49 consultation fee. We lowered that currently from the charge to the actual access to it, just to correspond with the contract set. And then finally, we made some very slight adjustment to the trustee's fiduciary liability insurance because of the went from 38, 48 to 39, 90 to 150 bucks. You know, the penny is what we shifted around. So that basically, so that when we actually now we finalize the budget rate, so that when we monitor performance, we're going real months right into it.
And on that renewal, we did have to add a third laser. Is that
correct?
Okay.
You did. Yeah. And you'll get into that when the floor department gets into the budget.
Okay.
And you're looking at reinsurance recovery, you'll see how that actually plays out. We had like something $1 million in excess of our normal inflation, but we recover less than that full amount because of the effect of lasers in that year.
Right.
And then what we do,
any questions from? Think we're good on that one. Okay. Approval of the meeting minutes.
So you got the regular knee session, and we'll collect those when they're done because they're subject to attorney client privilege.
I didn't see any discrepancies on them when I reviewed them. I don't know. There were only two, which is nice. And then we did get, you were going to, I think we had the June 3rd posted on the website. Thank you. So we had a March and I think a June that, and everything on the website is meeting, corresponding with what we're looking at. So, and so I didn't have any. Did you have any changes that you wanted or that you found anything? Okay. All righty.
I'll make a motion to approve both the March and the June minutes, since there's no changes on either one of them.
A second.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Do you want want me to sign these copies, Storm, or do you have some other ones that, okay? Okay. And the 4.3, approval of February, May financials.
So I'm going to go over maybe the most recent ones that you have at this point. So in May, the overall revenue was $630,000. Expenses were at $380,000. Our year-to-date cash position is $210,000. The estimated incurred but not paid liability is at $1.4 million. And on year surplus is at $2.3 million. In May, the gross revenue came in at 15% of the budget. And the purchasing income was at 416%, and that was due to the trust ability to invest more funds than earn interest than originally was anticipated. Under the claim funds, that includes medical, RX, dental, and then that's going to be less than any stop loss reimbursements or prescription rebates. This is the plan received a stop loss reimbursement in May, the total of $75,000. And a prescription rebate totaling $50,000. And both of those items contributed to the month's positive financial position. The gold plan medical claims are running at 120%, and the gold claims are running over budget, and that was due to they were brand new large claims that processed in May, totaling $148,000. Gold prescription, that's running over budget, and those are due to, again, specialty medications and high utilization. And then the silver shows at 469% for the month, and I think we talked about it before. That's because it's under budgeted at $471 for the month, and the claims are actually $1,900. So that's why it appears to be such a high percentage. The premiums are running right at just a little over 100% for the month. Your basic voluntary life and short-term disability are running over budget due to higher enrollment that was originally budgeted for. And then your basic life is running at 111 because you do have some employees that waive medical that are covered under the life and the census running over budget. So that's where that comes from. Claims administration is just under budget at 99%. And then finally, what I think what Aaron's speaking of, the truck had 14 yards of claims.
416,000 that we're not going to recover because of the lasers.
That's correct.
And how long does it take normally to turn that around?
Turn it around?
I mean, as far as getting the to recover.
Getting the reimbursement? I don't know if there's a specific time frame. I've seen they vary, and I've seen that it varies depending on the type of claim.
Okay.
So that's where I've seen the biggest differences.
Right. So 14, huh? So.
So if you did that, I'm sure just to put that all in perspective, if you take a look at it on a year-to-date on a cash basis, we're up $210,000, but we have another $470,000 savings. So we're coming up with about $350,000. So all things considered, it's been really hard work.
Well, it took a lot of hard work too. And I mean, even with these types of things that happened, I think, you know, you're right, we did.
Good to be conservative because you see we got the end, we picked up two cases we had last month.
for some, yeah. Any questions on the financials? Not too much to say about them. They are what they are. I know on the general clinic administrative expenses, it was kind of nice to see that March, April, May, June, a lot of those boxes have no numbers in them. That was kind of nice. And I appreciate you breaking out the legal, too, under the general operations, because I think we had put that, set aside that $50,000 because we were working through those questions when you came on as our consultants. And I think it was nice to have that broken out, so I appreciate you doing that. Anything else? All right, a motion to approve the February to May financial report as
I move we approve February to May financial reports.
Second.
Amy Barney?
Yes.
Al Christensen?
Yes.
Marcia Fox?
Yes. Okay, updates and announcements?
Yes, Madam Chair. Again, this payment got included. We just call this had an update with the change in the title. First one is on Gilmore. The start of Gilmore made an error in the setup on how they were doing the file feed to Gilmore all the way back to July of 2016. So they did not have indicators to point to what plan they were on. So it was called out. So then after some discussion with Gilmore, they ran a calculation and came up with $8,060 that was paid a year of the trust. And just a point of clarification, you might remember about a couple of years ago, UCA had a reason we did the same thing with Jeff and Unified, and I think you overset the 1800 bucks. The reason that happened, these are pure oversets. So somebody forgot to hit the right button on one of the other side. So I pointed out to you there, say you did. There was some discussion, thinking that's not right, but hey, what's the right way to do it? I think it's important to do that. When those, certainly you make a judgment when you take a shot. This is going to work, and that's not going to really have kind of a conversation made with your error. So the trust will make a whole hour down the bottom.
Well, and I appreciate them doing that because the downside of that would have been a lot more confrontational with having to go back to them.
Go back and get attorney involved.
That would have been messy. So I appreciate them doing that and you talking to them about it. So good.
And then we also went and discovered on that as a result of that one, digging back in, we found some retirees that had been enrolled in silver instead of gold. So we're going to go back and adjust those claims. But what this one points to, and it has been a discussion over the past, the district's not auditing those bills. And so there's multiple checks in there. So when Mike comes back, we talked with him, we have to kind of go back and hit that too. And there's a handful of audits that can be done. You can run an alpha list off the payroll system to check the cheater assignments. We run that same list off on Gilmore side or Vision side and whatnot, just to make sure that everybody's collecting. Once you've done that, it is somewhat tedious, but we've done it in the past where you call. You send two people across or two alpha lists and call them. And just call back and forth and you get it done. But once you're done, then you just have to audit the changes. That's not happening. So we just want to make sure we'll work with staff to make sure that process gets put in. In fairness to them, I know they've been burdened with this transition on their side.
Of course.
So once they get the kinks out of that, then we go back in and work with them on setting up some kind of process and make sure the audit's happening.
And would that be for just the retirees?
No,
for all of them.
On the actives. We help clients who set those up in the past, and frankly, we found not here in Galveston, far away. We found Arizona back years. And frankly, what typically happens, the employee signs up, they really don't know.
Right.
They sign up for family, and they get the child drink. You know, when you do 7 or 8 years later,
right.
You let go. So it would be nice to make sure the revenue is coming in as active as it should be. deal with my whole charter to get off your turn. It is complex on things like voluntary term, like with the 5-year aid bans. You can forget the ban for 3 years. Because there's enough cash flow running through the account, all of this stuff. So it'd just be good.
Well, hopefully having everything going, their enrollment going through the business, it'd be easier to, like, export that.
The enrollment portals are really good, and we've seen those, because even if they're wrong, they're consistently wrong with the programming thing, so it goes straight across. When you're doing paper, it's all over the place. And that's kind of like this. I think, again, it'd be good to get settled down on the enrollment portal. Once that's proofed out, then they can create something, go through, do the proofing, and set it up to do that big justice.
Okay. And then you can just report back. I read it. I didn't see anything that was different than others that I've seen. I mean, it's not, and it really wasn't that much different than the one that we had before from last year, if I remember right. And they just added or restated the privacy policy. I don't know if you guys feel like you want to have him on the phone or ask any questions.
My role is
very straightforward. So I don't really see a reason to have them on. No, I think we're good. And then you got one more good news?
Yeah, the eye care.
Lake Havasu Eye Care.
I'm sorry.
Lake Havasu Family Eye Care has been added.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yay! Good job, Havasu. Keeping up.
I spoke with her in their office, and they'll go through 3 years, and I'm glad it worked out, because a lot of people are going to thank you for our side.
Yeah. Some smiles.
Yeah, you give a small town. It can be really bad, but I'm going to get very helpful.
Sometimes it's helpful.
Sometimes it, yeah. Well, we're happy that she's back. Are we really finished? My goodness.
There's no new business on the way.
I know I was out of town at the last school board meeting, where they approved me to be on the board again, but I had, in my application, I had put down that I could do it for a year because I had thought my term was up in June of 2020. So I'm still sticking to that. So I just want everybody to know that. So it's not in May of 2020. No one's surprised. So I'll still come to meetings. So.
Well, that's good to hear. You're never a thorn. You might be. Do we have any other, not so fast. is there anything else that we need to add to the agenda for next? So we've got the selling the rest of those items, and I think that's the only, the retiree plan, and then we're finished with all the renewals, right? Those are all, or do we have one more out there that we had to renew, or they're finished?
Another resource is Marketplace, I guess. I've learned from a bunch of different people that Marketplace is a very good avenue to sell things. So that would be something in addition to our other avenues we look at, maybe put it on Marketplace.
All right. Well, there's nothing else.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Yes.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Amy, are you going over to...
Adjourned at 5:00.